You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of The Hate U Give, a famous work by Angie Thomas. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Angie Thomas was born in Jackson, Mississippi, where she witnessed a shootout at the age of 6. The next day, her mother took her to the library to show her that there was hope in the world. Thomas cites this moment as her inspiration to start writing. She went on to earn a BFA from Belhaven University, where she was the first Black student to graduate in creative writing. As a student, Thomas saw the shooting of Oscar Grant, a young African-American man who was shot by police, in the news, and this became a major influence on her first novel, The Hate U Give. Thomas cites Tupac Shakur, American rapper, 1971-1996, as one of her sources of inspiration. In fact, the title of The Hate U Give was taken from his Thug Life tattoo, which is an acronym for The Hate U Give Little Infants Fucks Everyone. Thomas originally gravitated towards fantasy novels, but a college professor suggested that her experiences were unique, and that her work could give a voice to people in her community who had been silenced. The work. As a college student, Angie Thomas was horrified when she heard about the shooting of Oscar Grant in 2009. She reacted to this news by beginning to write the story that would become The Hate U Give. It began as a short story for her senior project, but it quickly expanded. After college, she set the project aside to work at her local newspaper, but after hearing about further wrongful shootings and imprisonments in African-American communities across the United States of America, she resumed writing The Hate U Give. The novel centers around the unjust shooting of a young African-American man, Khalil, and how his community reacts, with particular focus on the reaction of his childhood friend, Starr, who was with him at the time of his death. Despite Thomas's initial concerns that publishers might not like the Black Lives Matter-inspired subject, the novel has generally been well received. Summary. The Party. The Hate U Give opens with 16-year-old Starr Carter, narrator and protagonist of the novel, reluctantly attending a party in Garden Heights, the area where she lives, which is mostly populated by the Black community, with her friend Kenya. As well as being friends, Kenya and Starr share an older half-brother, 7. At the party, Starr bumps into her childhood friend and crush, Khalil, who offers to drive Starr home when shots are fired at the party. On the way home, a police officer, whom Starr later names 115, his badge number, pulls Khalil's car over and orders him out of the car. 115 orders Khalil to stay still while he returns to the patrol car, but Khalil goes to open the door to check on Starr. 115 shoots Khalil and then points his gun at Starr, telling her not to move until backup and an ambulance arrive. Secrecy. The following week, Starr returns to Williamson Prep, a private school in a predominantly white area, and decides not to tell anyone that she witnessed Khalil's murder. By this time, Khalil's photo has been plastered all over the news, with him being portrayed as a drug dealer and gang member in order to justify 115's actions. Things are especially tense between Starr and her friend Haley, who unfollowed her Tumblr after she posted a photo of Emmett Till, a young African-American man who was lynched in Mississippi in 1955. Fueled by concern over Starr's erratic behavior, Haley and their mutual friend Maya ask Starr if she knew Khalil, which she denies. She also refuses to explain why she is upset to her white boyfriend, Chris, who also attends Williamson Prep. The funeral. Starr attends Khalil's funeral and meets April Afra, who is a member of Just Us for Justice, an organization which seeks to hold police accountable for their actions in cases such as Khalil's. She tells the congregation at the church that Khalil was unarmed at the time of his death. Kenya's father, King, a notorious gangbanger, arrives at the funeral and places a gray bandana on his casket, signifying that he was a King Lord, member of King's gang. This appalls Starr, as she is unable to believe that Khalil was involved with drugs and gangs. Aftermath. On the evening of Khalil's funeral, riots begin breaking out in Garden Heights in protest, as the police have announced they will not arrest 115 and mentioned an unnamed witness. Starr's father, Maverick, goes to protect the local store he owns with Starr, where they find Devante, a young king lord who is hiding from King. Maverick offers to help Devante, as he used to be a king lord and managed to leave the gang by pleading guilty to a crime which King committed. Maverick asks his brother-in-law, Carlos, to take him in, as Carlos lives outside of Garden Heights. Meanwhile, Starr learns that Khalil's case is going to be presented before the grand jury and agrees to meet with April Afra, who persuades her to speak at the trial. Starr learns that 115's defense is that he mistook a hairbrush.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.